With Zapier Chatbots, you now have access to the full transcript. And what's so great about this is that you can trigger a zap when a conversation ends and grab that transcript. You can do things like add it to a Zapier table or any other app you have. You can send a notification in Slack or Gmail. You can even add in AI steps to go ahead and summarize the transcript and pull out the pieces that are going to be most relevant to your team. So let me show you how this works. When you're in Zapier Chatbots, all you need to do is go to the Actions tab when you're editing a chatbot. You can click Add Action, and from here, you'll see Run a Zap as one of the actions. You'll scroll down to choose when you want to run the zap. Right now, it's only at the end of the conversation, and you click Create Zap. The zap will wait about 5 minutes after a conversation has completed to make sure it captures the full transcript history. So now you'll be in the zap editor and you'll see that trigger. We'll go ahead and click in and click test trigger. Now, if you've had a conversation with your chatbot already, or maybe someone else has on your site, then you're going to see some of that testing information here ready to go. You can also just go ahead and quickly create a conversation, and then you can pull that in as test data to use. When you look at the test data, one of the values is that full conversation transcript, and that's what we're after. We'll continue with the selected record, and now this is where you can do so many different things with Zapier. There's 7,000 plus different apps and tools you can work with. In this example, let's go ahead and just add it to a Zapier table. So we'll click Zapier Tables and then Create Record. Now, I've already set up a Zapier table for this. I'll show you what that looks like. It's a simple table with a date time field, the full transcript, the session ID, and then I also have a placeholder field here for summary, where later on we can add in an AI step to the zap to summarize the transcript. But for now, we'll get the basic details squared away. So back in the zap, I'll click continue, and this is where I just need to choose that table. There it is, that chatbot conversations table. And here, I'll just go ahead and fill in the fields from that chatbot trigger. It's really easy to do this. You just click into the field, and then you'll see all the different fields you can map. I'm going to put created at. That gives me a date timestamp, and that's going to be perfect for that Zapier table field. Then full transcript. I'll do the same thing here. I can even search for available fields. There it is, full conversation transcript. So now that I have those fields mapped, I'll click continue and I can go ahead and test the step. Awesome. I'll look at the connected table to see if it came through, and it looks like it did. The date time, we click in to see the full transcript. So now when I publish this zap, it will go live, and anytime someone has a conversation with my chatbot, then that conversation ends, it will store it into my table that I can reference later on. Now, because chatbots is so tied into Zapier and all of the different actions you can take there, the sky really is the limit with what you want to do. Like I mentioned, you can add a step to send a notification. Maybe I want to do it via Slack, and I can choose something like send channel message. So then this zap would trigger anytime a conversation's ended, add it to the table, and send a Slack message for my team to be notified. They can go in and look at the full transcript history. Or maybe I want to add an AI summary step. That would be super easy to do. If we add in something like ChatGPT, the event would be summarize text. You just add your account and then map in that full transcript. Now this step will summarize the full transcript. We'll go ahead and test that. And it'll push out a pretty concise summary, which is amazing. With that, we can just map the summary into the summary field, click continue, and then this zap will start doing that for us automatically. Now, if you are paying to collect lead information from Zapier chatbots, where it'll actually ask for the name or email and other things, that gets automatically stored in a table already. And so if you did want to add a transcript to those lead records, you could do that very easily. You can see here in this table, this is collecting lead information from conversations. It stores a chatbot session ID, and that ID will match with the transcript. The transcript also has a session ID. So in the zap, you'd set it up to trigger when the conversation is over and then go find the record in Zapier tables. You would find it by the chatbot session ID, and you would say it is exactly the same as the chatbot session ID from that conversation that just ended. So when it does that, it's gonna go find the right record. And now when it finds that, then you would go ahead and add in a update record step in Zapier Tables to pull in the full transcript there. So take this new feature for a spin. Chatbots and Zaps just got more connected. Your chatbot conversations got more automated. So be sure to take a look.